Welcome to part 3 of my 3D screencasting series. In today's episodes, we're going to take a transparent screenshot and combine it with full motion video footage to create an individual separate object that can be animated in 3D space inside of After Effects. Let's get started. And now we'll move on and go ahead and grab that transparent control panel that we grabbed with Snagit, and we'll drag it down here into the mix. And what we need to do is actually line this control panel up with this panel on the screen recording. I'm going to hit D to get my pointer tool back, and I'm actually going to zoom in real tight here onto this corner of the desktop. And the easiest way that I know to actually line things up is actually to come up to the View menu and choose Show Rulers. And we'll go ahead and drag some guides out here. So I'm going to drag a guide up along the top edge here. And I'm going to come over and I'm going to grab another guide and line it up on the left edge. We'll back out just a little bit. You can see our control panel. And we'll just drag it and it should snap right to those guides. Okay. Now I'm going to get rid of the guides because sometimes they get in the way. So just go ahead and clean those up. You can see these things line up pretty good, but they're actually not as good as I'd like it to be. So I'm just going to tweak this a little bit, changing the position here just with my arrow keys. Okay, I'm much happier with the way that edge looks right at this point. Let's see if I toggle the visibility back and forth. Looks pretty good. So we'll back out and we'll move on to our next step, which is to actually duplicate this fixed screen area. And you'll see why a few steps from now, but we're just going to go ahead and Command D to duplicate. And I'm going to take this top one, and I'm actually going to solo it. Actually, I'm going to solo both of those layers just for a second. And I'm going to make sure I have the top one selected. I'm going to go ahead and grab my pen tool, and we're going to do some more rotoscoping here. So, again, for the purposes of this demo, we're just going to real quickly rotoscope the areas of change inside of this window. And you'll see why in a few steps. I'm going to create another area that I'm going to cut out up here. And again, I would be much more careful and come in and really tighten things up and clean these up, but for the purposes of this demo, we're just going to do quick and dirty. The next thing I'm going to do is actually come down in and toggle off one of those soloing. So I'm just seeing this layer that I've rotoscoped, and you can see I've just got these areas of change. This combo box, which shows the file path, which will change, and this area inside of the control panel where all of the mouse movement and the window refreshes are occurring. So I've got that cleaned up real nicely. I'm going to switch to my pointer tool here. We'll unsolo this. And now we're going to go ahead and drag this one up above the control panel here. So I've got my screen video rotoscoped above the transparent window that we grabbed with Snagit. And I'll go ahead and select both of those. I'm going to pre-comp those. So layer, pre-compose, and we'll just call this window. Okay, if I solo this, you can see I've got this nice transparent window and all of the movement and action that takes place inside of it right here in one layer. So we'll go ahead and unsolo that.
That was pretty cool stuff, wasn't it? We've managed to isolate our window from the desktop, and that means we're pretty close to being able to animate it. But there's still a little bit of work to do, which means you'll need to come back tomorrow and check out the next episode, where we'll learn how to clean up our desktop and get rid of the window, but leave the mouse movements so that we can animate that window out and have the mouse transfer from the desktop onto the window. I'll see you then.